Hello students, once again I am back with all of you to sum up the chapter that we started in the last video, why do we fall ill. In the last video we were discussing about infectious and the non-infectious diseases, and I had told you about the infectious diseases are the ones which are usually spread by microorganisms from an infected person to a healthy person. The means of spread may be air, water or any kind of microbe vector, whereas the non-infectious diseases are the ones which arise due to an individual's personal weakness or any kind of dysfunctioning within the body and is not spreaded by one to the other. Now over here there is a very important discussion being done in the yellow colored box about peptic ulcers. Before the Indian independence, there was a time when peptic ulcer used to be a chronic disorder and was not curable or was considered as incurable disease. Until and unless the birth of a prodigy child, Robin Warren, in 1937 took place, who studied in detail the bacterium causing these peptic ulcers. The bacterium was introduced as Helicobacter pylori. Finally, the Barry Marshall, who was born in 1951, joined the interesting findings of Robin Warren, and they combinedly showed the interesting discoveries regarding this bacterium, and finally we were able to treat these peptic ulcers by certain antibiotics. For such kind of achievements, Marshall and Warren received the Nobel Prize for Physiology and Medicine in 2005. The ways in which diseases spread and the ways in which they can be treated and prevented at the community level would be different for different diseases. For example, if it is an infectious disease, it needs to be treated as such, and whereas if it is a non-infectious disease, it needs to be treated as such. For example, if we could talk about the Indian scenario 2 to 3 decades back, polio was a deadly disease within India. But now, through a massive vaccination program, the Indian government is now able to eradicate this threat to mankind completely through the Indian scenario. पोलियो जैसी बीमारी को आज इंडियन गवर्नमेंट ने मैसिव वैक्सीनेशन प्रोग्राम से पूरी तरह हटा दिया है. 1 से 5 साल तक के बच्चों को 2 बूंद जिंदगी की पिलाई जाती हैं. यू ऑल आर वेरी वेल इंट्रोड्यूस्ड विद इट, 2 बूंद जिंदगी की. एंड अमिताभ बच्चन हैव बीन द ब्रांड एम्बेसडर फॉर दिस काइंड ऑफ हेल्थ प्रोग्राम फॉर द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट. नाउ कम्स द इन्फेक्शियस डिसीजेस. Let me tell you, as I told you, the infectious diseases are most commonly caused by certain microorganisms, and these microorganisms may be bacteria, viruses or a fungi. That means the infectious diseases may be a bacterial one, a fungal one or a viral one. Common cold, as we know, is caused by a special category of viruses known as rhinoviruses. Similarly, most common of the skin problems are caused by fungal infections, in which the doctors usually advise patients not to share their towels and undergarments with the infected persons. Right? Some of them are viruses, some are bacteria, fungi, some are single-celled animals or protozoans. Some diseases are also caused by multicellular organisms such as worms of different kinds. Ground worms, which are usually a parasite in the human intestine, also causes certain disorders. Over here on this page, page number 181 of your NCERT books, figure 13.A show a SARS virus is usually, let me tell you, is a virus that causes a respiratory syndrome in which the respiratory capacity of a person is drastically affected or impacted. Whereas in the B region, you can see Staphylococci, the bacteria which can cause acne on the skin. The scale of image is indicated by the line at top left. whereas in the figure 13.1c, trypanosomas are being indicated, which are responsible for sleeping sickness. Trypanosoma, let me tell you, are a category of organisms known as protozoans. In figure 13.b, picture of Leishmania is indicated, which causes kala azar or black fever. Whereas in figure 13.1e, picture of an adult roundworm, Ascaris lumbricoides, is indicated and is the technical name of, technical name, the scientific name of roundworm, and this is usually a parasite of human small intestine. Common examples of infectious diseases includes AIDS, influenza, dengue, typhoid, fever, cholera, tuberculosis, anthrax. But the thing that needs to be much focused over here is that which of these are caused by which kind of bacteria, virus or fungi. Like the common examples of diseases caused by viruses are common cold, influenza, dengue fever and the AIDS. Right? Whereas the diseases like typhoid, fever, cholera, tuberculosis and anthrax are caused by bacteria. I told you many common skin infections are caused by fungi, and the protozoan microbes cause many familiar diseases such as malaria which is caused by Plasmodium, and kala azar which is caused by Leishmania. Now, the categories of infectious agents are very important to be known so as to treat them. Till the time scientists or biologists will not be knowing the category of organisms causing the disease, the microbiologists will not be able to design a proper treatment for the disease. Like for example, viruses have a certain different behavior to that of bacteria, and therefore a viral disease needs to be treated differently than that of a bacterial disease. Right? Antibiotics, let me tell you what are antibiotics in the chapter or in this part of biology. Again and again you will be coming through this term. Antibiotics are certain special chemical substances that are synthesized by microorganisms like bacteria and are designed to kill bacteria itself. Interesting या fascinating चीज यहाँ पे ये है बेटा कि जो antibiotics हैं वो bacteria ही produce करते हैं और इनसे bacteria को ही मारा भी जाता है. Means they are used in turn to kill bacteria only. Right? So that is a very interesting thing about these substances. Antibiotics are a very important, or I can say a very essential part of our life in present day-to-day life. Right? Now we should be discussing about the means of spread. The means of spread of diseases may be air. Such kind of diseases are known as airborne diseases, for example common cold. Similarly, the diseases which are spread through water are called as waterborne diseases, like cholera, dysentery, etc. Whereas some of the diseases are spread by living vectors, that we say the microbe vectors. For example, the female Anopheles mosquito is the vector organism for malaria disease. The female Anopheles mosquito transfers the Plasmodium from one infected person to another healthy one. And some infectious diseases also spread through sexual contact of one infected partner to a healthy partner. Other than this, disease like AIDS can also be transmitted through infected blood transfusions. It can also be transmitted to a baby from his or her mother at the time of pregnancy or during lactation or breastfeeding. Right? Now comes the organ specific and the tissue specific manifestations. The disease causing microbes enter the body through these different means. Where do they go then? The body is very large, and when compared to the microbes, so there are many possible places, organs or tissues where they could go. Do all microbes go to the same tissue or organ, or they go to the different ones? That means in this section of chapter we are going to deal about the specific organ or the tissue of body which is getting impacted or affected by the infection or the microbe. For example, if we talk about HIV, as and when the HIV or the human immunodeficiency virus enters into a living system, it takes over the control of complete immune system of the body. it starts damaging the T lymphocyte cells, which are meant for providing an immunity in the body or for producing antibodies, and thus the person is not able to fight against small infections or diseases even. The malaria causing microbes entering through a mosquito bite go to the liver and then they go to the red blood cells, and therefore the number of RBCs goes on decreasing while someone is suffering from malaria. The virus causing Japanese encephalitis or brain fever will similarly enter through a mosquito bite, but in this way the virus causing Japanese encephalitis will be making it targeted brain. तो वहां पे जो टारगेट होगा वायरस का वो क्या होगा, ब्रेन होगा, राइट. तो इन केस ऑफ निमोनिया विच इज कॉज्ड बाय निमोनिया इन्फ्लुएंजा, राइट, द टारगेट इज द रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट ऑफ पर्सन. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट टाइफाइड इज कॉज्ड बाय अ पैथोजेनिक बैक्टीरियम कॉल्ड सेल्मोनेला टाइफी. If we talk about fungal infections, the target site of fungus are the skin of organism. That is why the skin, the rashes appears on the skin, or acne, pimples appears on the skin, as in when the organism is infected by a fungal infection. Right? So this means the organ level or the tissue level manifestations. We should stop the video till now. In the next portion, we will be further discussing about the principles of treatment for a disease and how we can prevent certain diseases from spreading from one infected person to other healthy one.